Morning, guys. Today I'm going to look at the my turntable. It's probably the best turntable I own. I also have a Stanton one that's pretty nice as well. This one I kind of feel is more I didn't say I can't really say that. They're pretty much on the same realm in my opinion. But Pioneer is definitely a the name brand over the other one, which is a Stanton. It's kind of like a Technics 1200 MK2 ripoff, more or less, but it gets the job done. Anyway, so on this turntable, it's not so much a turntable itself that really makes it stand out, although it is nice. Pretty heavy, decent build quality. The quality in this one actually comes from the cartridge I have on it. Now, I was just saying the other day that I don't really spin vinyl very much, which actually kind of put me in the mood to do it a little bit. I'm not gonna freaking keep much on because I have that little protective clip for the needle. Just so I don't, piss off the YouTube police. This one here, I actually bought a brand new, it's nice and shiny, brand new dust cover for it. But I need to get hinges. Today I'm gonna play, probably do some Rolling Stones. I have it on CD too, but I've been itching to get a turntable, a little bit of a workout. Anyway, I usually keep the tone arm in the up position because I don't like to really drop the needle on the record by hand, just because human error and imperfections, you could, scratch it and you'll always hear that audible pop. Now, for those of you who know, I like my music to sound crystal clear. I don't really care for background noise too much, including pops and clicks. I know a lot of people like the pops and clicks. I don't. I want it to sound produced. I want it to sound, crystal clear. I don't want to hear any of that background noise. All right. So we have your typical 33 and 45 RPM adjustment. You have your speed adjustment, which is nice. I mean, it's pretty cool. And I'll get into what these little dots are too. I know a lot of people, especially if it's not your thing or you're not really into it, you might not know what these dots are for. And I'll get into that then. But basically, let's start by firing it up. Obviously, the first thing you do is set your receiver up to the proper input. That's a no-brainer, but then we click that out like that. Put this down for a second. And then you take your cue lever and now you're spinning vinyl. Actually, look what I have. I haven't slowed down for the Billy Joel album still. So it's actually playing at the wrong speed. So, turn this down. So it's a 33 RPM record, and we're in the United States. So, and United States electricity runs at 60 hertz. So what that means. And I don't even know if that strobe will show up on the phone or not. It might not. So I might be talking to you for no reason about this. But anyway, it's going to create the illusion that when playing at the proper speed, the bottom row on your platter here is going to appear to be stationary and not moving. So listen to it while I do it. Right there. I got the speed dead on accurate right there. Now, if I click it up to 45 RPM, it should already be adjusted for 45 RPM at 60 hertz. So I'm gonna click this up to 45, and then it should be the third row on the platter that appears to be stationary instead of the bottom row. Let's see. Actually, I have to adjust that too. So if I was playing at 45, there you go. Now you can see it's the third one. Now it's back down at 33. So pick the queuing up. I really can't think of much of a reason. And actually, this does have auto return too. I'll show that quick. So if we're all the way down at the end of the album, well, that's actually skipping over this way because I got the turntable weight set to be as light as possible. And we're still moving at perfect speed. Speed it up. That sounds funny, don't it? Is that's all the anti-skate and the weight. The weight's actually a nice feature to have because you want to have, the way I usually set it up, is that you want the weight on the tone arm to be as far back as you can without it tilting up. What that does is that makes you, it gives you less pressure on the vinyl itself, so it's not putting as much wear on your records. Now, obviously you don't want it, the weight back so much that it goes flopping up every time you walk by it, but you do want to make sure that's not, you're not putting full pressure on the album. To me, that's what that's for. That's what I you know, how I use that feature. As for the speed adjustment, I really can't think of much use for it under normal circumstances for, you know, the everyday consumer. Although, like I think I might have mentioned it a couple minutes ago, there is, however, one use I have for it, and I'll show that in a second. As soon as you see the auto return feature. About to happen right now. I go up and go right back home. Oh, it did it. Not ready to catch it because I didn't think it was going to, but it did it. Back down, and I'll put that back up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop the video here, and I'm going to show you the one circumstance I actually use the speed adjustment for, other than switching between 33 and 45, which I'm pretty sure with 33 and 45, you shouldn't have, if you have the speed set right, it should be good for both. I might have to spray some contact cleaner in the pots here. When I got this turntable, I actually got it for free off my stepdad. He got off a buddy of his, and he was going to use it, but decided against it. And I inherited it, and I love it. I think it's a great turntable, honestly. It was well worth spending the money. Like, this is for this whole set, it was like $600. It's a cartridge, the stylus, and this little headpiece here. So, yep. So I'm going to switch the albums out quick, and I will show you the one circumstance that I actually use a speed adjustment for. It's actually pretty funny. And Billy Joel was not happy about it either. All right, so anyway, I'm back with the original press on Family Productions before Billy Joel got signed to Columbia of his debut Cold Spring Harbor album. Now, this is, long story short, I have a whole entire video of this on my other channel called 50 Years of Billy Joel, the Cold Spring Harbor Story, or Story of Cold Spring Harbor, something on the lines of that. And I go through this in pretty good detail, and I'm going to be doing another touch-up of it when I copy this to cassette. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm waiting on my Marantz 5220 cassette deck to get here so I can do it on a high-quality machine and get the best transfers possible with the speed corrected. And I'm going to be recording it onto, and it was not cheap at all, a Maxell UDS 2 Type 2 tape from the 1980s. These are hands down, I think they're the best blank cassettes you can get. They're cool looking too. Alright, so, take a listen to what I think is the best song on the album. And it is a little warped too, unfortunately. try to get line up the best that I can. Like I said, I'm doing it one-handed right now. Did I get it? No. Now I got it. It's way too fast, right? You can hear it. He sounds like a chipmunk. So we're gonna get this. That's better. So, basically, long story short on that, they obviously mastered the album at the wrong speed. Now, you could just say, hey, why don't you just get the Columbia re-release that came out in 1983? It's like, well, you can, but the mix is totally different on more than half of the songs. Like, Everybody Loves You Now is a different mix. There's stuff added to it, stuff taken out of it. Some of the songs were cut in half. Some of them had, like, guitar solos and crap ripped out of it. It's just not the same experience. That's why I'm going to go through the trouble of doing that transfer. Because I'm a diehard Billy Joel fan. But anyway, getting off topic here. That's my demo of the Pioneer Model PL-516 turntable. Like I said, I think it's a quality product. I would recommend it. You're not going to get one for super cheap. But then again, what good can you get for super cheap? I'm thinking about getting some better rubber mounts for it. And if anybody knows where I can get a set of hinges, like proper hinges for this dust cover, please comment and let me know, because I've been trying for a while to locate some, because I want it to be able to lift up. I don't want it to keep taking it on and off each time. But in any event, for now, I guess the way I have it set up now is just gonna have to do. It's gotta go back on. Go perfect. And also I need a new one of these for it, a new clamp for the arm. Anyway guys, thank you for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.